Welcome. In this video, we will discuss the differences between the constellations of Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. They're also commonly known as the Great Bear and the Little Bear. Let's take a quick look at one of the legends that surrounds these two constellations. So Ursa Major is Latin for Great Bear, and Ursa Minor is Latin for Small Bear. And there are many myths and stories that surround these two constellations because they're so visible in the sky throughout many cultures. But one that stood out to me was one from Roman mythology. And in Roman mythology, Jupiter was the king of the gods, and he lusted after many women, one which happened to be Callisto, which was not his wife. His wife, Juno, tried to destroy Callisto by turning her into a bear, and Callisto's son, Arcas, almost shoots his mother because she's disguised as a bear and he was a hunter. But Jupiter was able to prevent the tragedy by placing them both in the sky. So if you take a look at these two pictures, this would be Ursa Major, represented by Callisto in Roman mythology, and then here we have Arcas, the son of Callisto, and you can see their shapes of the stars are different, and the size of them will be different as well. But this is just one of many mythologies that have popped up over the course of human history. Now, let's take a look at the pattern of Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. So looking at this picture, we are looking at Ursa Major. And the thing that probably stands out to you is the Big Dipper. And the Big Dipper is a smaller pattern within the larger constellation of Ursa Major, which looks like this. Okay. Now, these depictions of constellations can vary depending on which star maps you're looking at, but this is one version of the bear. I also found this version of the Great Bear, but hopefully what you should be seeing is the Big Dipper within this smaller constellation. And this is important because it will be used to point out other constellations in the sky. Now let's take a look at Ursa Minor, also known as the Little Bear. And it also has an alternate name of the Little Dipper. So in science, we often find that there are many names for the same thing and the constellation is the same case. So what you're looking at here is a shape of Ursa Minor. So it's similar to that of the Big Dipper, but still different in the sense that its handle is shaped in a different direction. Okay, it's smaller in size. And then if we go back to this photo, all the stars are of different magnitude. If we were to compare the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper side by side, the things I want you to notice are how the handle curves differently on the Big Dipper versus the Small Dipper. It curves up. This is much larger in size in the sky when you're comparing it to the Little Dipper. And with the Little Dipper, you only see three main stars. Polaris is one of them, and then you have these two stars, which are called the guardians of the pole because they circle around Polaris. However, if you look at the Big Dipper, all of these stars here have pretty much the same magnitude or the same brightness. So that is the way you can tell the difference between the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper and the way they're oriented towards each other. So why do we care about the Big Dipper at all? If we take a look at this picture, we can see how the Big Dipper, which is an asterism, a smaller part of a larger constellation, can point to the North Star. And the North Star is an important star because it doesn't appear to move in our sky, so we can use it as a directional point. So taking a look at Ursa Major, or the Big Dipper, situated right here, if we use the pointer stars, it can guide us right to where the North Star is. So the pointer stars will point us to Polaris, just like that. And here's taking a look at where Ursa Minor is, or the Little Dipper, in comparison to the Big Dipper. So the pots face each other, the pot part of the Dipper face each other and use the pointer stars to aim you to Polaris. Another reason that Ursa Major is such an important constellation is because the asterism within the Big Dipper will point to many other constellations in the sky. So take a look at this. It's a little bit grainy and not the most clear picture, but it has the essentials of what you need to know in order to find the other constellations using the Big Dipper. So here is where the Big Dipper is located. Hopefully you can see that. And then you arc to Arcturus. Arcturus is this bright star in the constellation of Botes, which is right there. So you arc to Arcturus and then you speed to Spica. Spica is a bright star in the large constellation of Virgo. Going back to the Big Dipper, use the pointer stars here to aim towards Polaris. Here's the Little Dipper. And then right here, go back to the pointer stars and you can find Leo the Lion. There's the backwards question mark and the back end of the lion. And it might help if I use this to help you point it out as well. So again, you have Ursa Major, you arc to Arcturus and you speed to Spica. You use the pointer stars to aim right to Polaris. And then the pointer stars can also aim you to Leo the Lion. Now this is a huge section of the sky. That's part of the reason why it's so grainy, is you have a lot of constellations here. But use the Little Dipper and the Big Dipper really to help you find all the other constellations throughout the sky and throughout the year. Let's get some more practice trying to identify the difference between Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. So this is a picture that a former student of mine took, and it's an awesome picture because it captures all of Ursa Major. So first thing you can look for is the Big Dipper within Ursa Major. If you're able to find that, you can find the different constellations. So let's take a look. Here is where Ursa Major is in this constellation shot. And then here is where Ursa Major is, or I'm sorry, the Big Dipper. So again, just getting more practice. Take a look at this constellation. Are you able to find the Big Dipper? Hopefully you can. Here's the handle, and here is the pot part of the Dipper, as I call it. And interesting enough, this star right here is called Alcor and Mizar, and it is an optical double star. And some people, if their vision is good enough, they can see it with the naked eye, they can see two separate stars right here. It has been used as an eye test in ancient cultures. So see if you're able to find that with your naked eye. And if you have a pair of binoculars or a telescope, aim it right there and you'll see a double star. Let's have a little bit more practice looking at a different picture. So here we're looking at three constellations actually, and we're hoping to find Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. So let me help you out. The first thing you want to look for is the Big Dipper. So use the pointer stars to help you find Polaris right there. And from there, you should be able to find the Little Dipper as it wraps down here. Now the constellation is also represented here is Draco, which wraps around and its tail goes through the Dipper. So that's how you can find the constellation Draco. It's a very large one and I don't have many pictures of it in its entirety, but this is one of the few that I do have. Let's take a look at one more picture to help us practice telling the difference between Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. This might be a good shot to press pause if you don't want me to go through and explain and give yourself a chance to actually look at the stars here and see if you can identify any patterns. So, what we're looking at here is two constellations, ones which I didn't go review in this video, but it is Cassiopeia, located right here. And Cassiopeia looks like a misshapen W or M depending upon its orientation in the sky. And that can also point you to Polaris. So here is Ursa Minor and the North Star. So here again is its shape. Its handle curves up. And if we were to look here, maybe you can see again where that constellation is situated. So, as a final review, Ursa Major and Ursa Minor are also known as the Great and Small Bear. They are constellations that can be seen all year round, so we classify them as circumpolar. In order to find them, you need to learn how to recognize the Big Dipper, which is a very obvious pattern to find in the sky, and then you use the pointer stars right here to point you to Polaris. And then Little Dipper arcs down this way, and you have the Guardians of the Pole as well. So there are a lot of different celestial objects which we didn't go through in this shorter video, but if you ever turn your telescope or binoculars to these different regions of the sky, you will find many amazing things. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video was helpful in order to help you tell the difference between Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. Remember to keep going outside, observe the stars, and when you have learned something and be able to identify it, please share it with others.